to 45 students there, K through 8.
Okay.
Growing up in Blunts Creek, and I know there are some others that live down that way as well, I didn't know about a new housing development, but I can tell you that anyone that was in Blunts Creek 10 years ago and hasn't been back since, when they went back, they wouldn't even recognize
it. Yep.
And now, what Dr. Phipps is talking about with a population study, how many children live in those homes, I don't know. But I know there are a lot of houses that have been built in Blunts Creek, and of course, that's right on the line between Snowden and Chocolatey Middle. And I feel pretty sure that Snowden has some space that we don't. So, I mean,
yeah.
I understand what you're saying.
And it's not isolated just to this district. I think we're talking about that as a countywide issue. And we hear a lot about charter and private schools, and I want to tell you how I feel about it. I think parents having choice is a wonderful thing. And I think if we're the best game in town and we're doing a great job, people will choose to have their kids in our system.
One of their arguments is, well, if we're in business, you've got to do a better job, well, let's do
that's
a better
right.
job.
And if they're that's choosing right. to go somewhere else, we need to look at ourselves
that's right.
and not blame them for taking our kids, but ask why do they choose to have them go somewhere else and do a better job so that they choose to have them in our system.
Absolutely. Not if that's the limit of so-called competition. If it's out there, we do the right job, they'll come here.
We can
not, then that's the parents' choice.
Right, we just went to study. That's the thought.
Okay.
But I know for a fact there's some things that's happening here in our town and in our outlying areas that we will have them to do to keep up. And we don't have no choice, but we're going to have to.
Okay. Well, we want you to know where we're at and what's going on. We'll come back to you if we could, maybe by the month from that, and give you an idea of where we're at with that unit.
Okay.
And what we'll be able to do. If that would be okay. Thank you very much.
Just want to thank y'all again for helping
Absolutely.
Us out the last 3-5 years.
I think it's a comment. We're working.
I think 3-5. I've been there.
We're working with us.
And you know what's happening over your time. There again, I'm going to rule in big days to walk buildings that y'all need to build. That some things may be going on with the town. It's not just a building. You build a building, then you're talking about a water uses, or sewer uses, and that's what's attached to the town. That's where I think we need talk. Of course, we're getting said we're in the process, but we're getting ready to undertake some improvements to our sewer system, which is needed, which we can accommodate growth. And hopefully, the economy turns, and I feel like Chocolatey is going to do some booming, especially around the 17 cars. Everybody's paid any attention to it. That's some prime commercial land there that just going to take the service road off of one of the roads here. And it's going to bring more businesses, industrial park, if it ever gets off the street. But then you talk about more housing.
Well, and we don't want to sit back and then all of a sudden say we're sitting here with 60 more kids in this building because we weren't paying attention. I think planning is to have as much information as you can, as forward in time as much as you can, so that you can plan and make sure that you respond to it so that you're not reacting to it.
Right.
And that's what we want to do, is to be able to be proactive, but not just do it in a knee-jerk reaction. Have facts to back up what we're doing to justify the decisions that are made.
Yes, because in fact, bro, I don't want you to spend my money if you spend
it.
Agreed. Money. You want to go get more money?
Okay, thank you.